Okay, so what we're going to be looking at now is we're going to be looking at our Puppet tool. So in class, we talked about how to set up our project. So I have this Matthias Sturmer authentication painting for After Effects. Pretty much all this is I've gone ahead and added any color correction I need and any masks I need to individual layers so that I have very specific layers, my background, middle ground, foreground, that sort of thing. When we are importing these, we want to make sure it's importing as composition retained layer. So I'm going to hit import, and I just want to make sure it's editable. We do this that way we can change things inside of our composition and add the puppet tool that we're going to talk about in this video. Okay, so we have imported our Matthias painting for AE. When it comes in, if you've done this correctly, you'll have this little folder with all of your individual layers in it. Do be aware that if you still have any adjustment layers or things like that, they do come in as their own layer. They don't come in automatically merged. And then you should also have gotten this composition. Now there's two ways you can go about putting this down here. You can manually pull all of these down here, scale them up, or you can double click on the composition and it will generate for you, like so. Now, if you're going to do this double click composition section, you do need to make sure that your frame size is at 16 by 9 inches inside of Photoshop before you make it. This one is currently like 4 times that one's size. But for simplicity's sake, I'm just going to go ahead and use it. But you do want to make sure that you're using that 16 by 9 by 200 DPI before you even bring it into After Effects. So what happens is it automatically puts all of my layers here into perspective. So they're automatically scaled up. They're automatically here. The problem is they aren't in 3D space, which we'll worry about in a moment. But we can take them individually. So I'm going to solo our woman here so that I can move her with this puppet tool. So we don't need to worry about moving her in 3D space yet. We just want to get her overall motion in here. So the first thing we're going to do is I'm going to click on this puppet tool here, and I'm going to put pins everywhere that I think she might need to be still or have motion. So I'm going to put one on her elbow. It's going to automatically generate a mesh of her shape. I'm going to put one at each of her shoulders, her other elbow, the center of her chest, her stomach, down at her hand. I'm going to put one at her neck, chin, forehead, but also her wrist, fingers, and fingertips. So how these work is inside of your layer, you get this effects and puppet and this mesh one here. So when you click on that, you'll have this density. How dense is that mesh? How expanded out does it go? If you notice you have a lot of empty space between things, maybe you're working with flower petals or snowflakes, try increasing that expansion and density, and that might allow you to click more of what you might need. But for now, I'm going to come over here to this puppet tool, and I know that if I click on this one here, this is that puppet pin 13, 12 would be this one, 11, and 1. So I'm going to click on this 13 because I want to have her kind of making this motion like she is watching the other woman that's sitting here, or maybe she's making a rude gesture. Who knows? So I'm going to open this up, and how this works is currently right now it is based on position. You can also use start, which makes it so that you can't click it, you can't move it, it just does what it needs to do based on the other pins around it. A bend, so it will rotate, and advance, which will allow you to rotate, change the position, and scale. For right now, I'm going to leave this at position. And because we are at the beginning of our timeline, everywhere that we have created a pin has set a keyframe. We can tell that because it's got a blue stopwatch and not a gray stopwatch, as well as the fact we have this little diamond right here that is blue, which will add or remove a keyframe based on where you are on the timeline. So if I come out just a little bit, I'm going to go maybe to 4 seconds. I'm going to take her fingers and move them down. They will warp quite heavily, but that's why you have to move the next one below with it. Like so. So now we get her arm is moving down, and we can see that because we have these little handles right here that show the original's position to the new position, and when we hover over where she originally was, we get the outline of her actual mesh. So if we scrub on the timeline, because we have moved on the key on the keys here. So we have our original timeline spot to our new keyframe spot. Because we moved on the timeline, we will get motion. If you don't get any motion, that is probably because you did not move your time slider. So now, if we come in here, I can also take a look at maybe her head and neck. So if I click her neck here, maybe I want to open this one and her other two for her head up. Maybe I want to have her lean back as her arm comes down. So I'm going to have this one right here. I'm going to change this maybe to bend, and you'll see we get a different section here, and I can rotate that, and you'll see it kind of warps her to get her to rotate. So maybe this top one needs to lean back, and this one needs to lean back. So we have this one bend, and these two still in position to move her. We also have her shoulder over here. Maybe we need to have her shoulder do something different. So I'm going to scroll down to where this puppet pin 3 is. And if I change this, I can do starch. And pretty much what starch says is, hey, anytime something happens to a pin next to mine, just go ahead and move how it thinks it needs to move. Or we can do advanced, which works as all the different types other than starch. We can move the position of her shoulder. We can rotate her shoulder if we click and drag along this circle. Or we can click on this little box and scroll out or in to zoom in. I'm going to go ahead and change this back to starch. So now we have all this motion, except her head does not move because when I made it, when I changed the keyframes, I did not move my time slider. So I'm just going to lightly lean her forward back to how she was. Going to move her pins just a little bit to how she was. So now she's ever so slightly moving her head when I move on my timeline. This is how we're moving and using the puppet tool to create our project 2. So we would repeat this process again on each individual part of our animation. So now, after a little bit of playing around, I have my full animation. I have my lady leaning, gesturing forward, her leaning back, and a candle moving. So if I hit play, you'll see mine is caching before it plays back. I have this green line that's growing. She's moving ever so slightly as it plays. I'm just going to pause. My timeline is quite long. My animation stops at 4. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this little work area end button and just click and drag it down to just a little after my 4. What this does is says, hey, I want my timeline to end here. I don't need it to continue. So you see my motion goes really fast where it is cached and green. And so now I just have to wait for it to get all the way across. Okay, so my animation is fully cached. So now you see she leans back subtly. She moves forward. Our candle flickers here just a little bit. We've got some nice overall movement. And my puppet tool work is now complete. I still might need to change some things, maybe make her flick her wrist a little bit more. It does stretch quite a bit. We want to make sure we are keeping proportions. So what we'll do is I'll come over to her, woman standing, open her back up, go into her puppet tools, click on her, make sure I have the puppet tool selected so I can see my pins. And all I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to this last frame here, and you can see her arm does stretch quite a bit. I'm just going to move that a little closer to her actual hand to kind of try to keep some proportions so she doesn't look like she's stretching. We want to make sure we're trying to keep as much of our original kind of feel as we can. So you can see her arm no longer looks like it's stretching. It actually almost looks like it's shrinking just a little bit. So I could probably exaggerate that just a little bit. There we go. Now her arm stays at about the same. All right, and that is all that we're going to talk about for our After Effects puppet tool.